अटेंड।
हाय गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द एपीएम क्वाडकॉप्टर बिल्डिंग ट्यूटोरियल्स। इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव शोन द कंप्लीट कनेक्शंस विद द एपीएम बोर्ड। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी शोइंग यू कंप्लीट सेटअप ऑफ द फ्लाइट कंट्रोलर। फॉर दैट यू नीड टू इंस्टॉल द सॉफ्टवेयर कॉल्ड मिशन प्लानर। फॉर डाउनलोडिंग दैट सॉफ्टवेयर यू कैन डायरेक्टली विजिट द लिंक गिवन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स, और यू कैन इजिली फाइंड इट इन द गूगल। First, connect your system to the internet. Then open Mission Planner software. Next, connect your flight controller board to the computer. Now you have to set the COM port here. To know the COM port, just go to Device Manager. In the ports, you can able to see the COM port of the board. So you have to select the same COM port in the Mission Planner software. After selecting the port, don't click on this connect button. Directly go to the setup. In that, go to install firmware. Our board will be not having any firmware. We need to load that firmware to the flight controller. You can able to see lot of options here. I'm doing the quadcopter, so I'm selecting this one. When you click on this, you get a message as, "Are you sure want to upload?" Just click on yes. And again, okay. So your firmware starts downloading and you can able to see the status here. Just wait until you get a done message. But sometimes you get a message in this way as, "Failed to download new firmware." This usually happens because your board and the firmware which is downloading from the internet doesn't match. In that case, you need to go with the previous firmware versions. For that, click on this pick previous. In the list, just select AC 3.6.7. AP 3.9.7. After selecting the firmware version, again click on your required project type. Then your firmware starts downloading again. After completing this process, click on this connect button. Then go to mandatory hardware. In that, frame type. Mine is the quadcopter, so I'm selecting this one. You can go according to your requirements. Next is the axle calibration. So first I'll tell you why it's important. In the every drone flight controller, there will be an accelerometer sensor which helps to determine the position and orientation of your quadcopter. So this data can be later used to stabilize the drone. For that, first we need to calibrate that sensor. Therefore, we need to follow some steps. Now click on this calibrate axle. First we need to place the quadcopter on the horizontal surface and press any key. Next we need to place it towards the left direction, and again we need to press some key. The same thing towards the right. Now it's showing the nose down. So the forward arrow mark is the nose. So just tilt it towards your forward direction. Now nose up, The aroma should come towards the up. Now, to place the vehicle on its back, just tilt your quadcopter. You get a message as calibration successful. This much is enough, and you need not to do anything here because this calibration is sufficient. Now coming to the compass, it's very important in the drones to determine the directions. To calibrate, click on this live calibration. Here you get an instruction to rotate your quadcopter in all the directions. Just click on OK. Now you need to rotate your drone in all the directions so that these points get connected. After completion, you get this message, click on OK. And next is the radio calibration. In this step, we need to set the maximum and minimum positions of all the sticks. For that, first switch on the transmitter. First, click on this calibrate. And now move all the sticks to their maximum and minimum positions. In your transmitter, if the channel 5 and 6 are in VIR A and B, just change it to switch C and D in the aux channels because these switches are required for changing the flight modes. If you don't know how to do this, you can refer to my video in the I button. Next is the servo output, which we are not using here. The next one is the ESC calibration. We are not using the software for this. I'll be showing you the another method at the end of this video, so we'll also skip this. Now coming to the flight modes, so here you get lot of flight modes which you can change by using the three mode switch. So you can able to see lot of options here. The altitude hold, in which you can make your drone hold at the same altitude, and the return to launch, in which if you activate that, your drone can land it to the original position. You can select any of the flight modes according to your requirements. Now we can easily change the flight modes using this switch. The last one is the fail-safe. Here you can set the minimum voltage. So when your battery reaches this low voltage, you can select two options as return to launch or land. And also there is another option as radio. Here you can also set it to return to launch when your drone loses the radio signals. So this is optional. If you need, you can set it according to your requirements. We are done with all software settings. Now go to data. Once check whether your board is arming or not. For arming, just take your rudder stick towards the right for few seconds. For disarming, you have to take it towards the opposite direction for few seconds. After this, click on this disconnect button and remove the USB cable. The last step is the ESC calibration. First, we need to calibrate all the ESCs individually using the transmitter and receiver. Here I'm just showing you the procedure using an extra ESC, but you have to repeat the same procedure individually for all the ESCs connected with the motor. For this, connect the ESC to the third channel of the receiver. First, switch on the transmitter and increase the throttle stick to maximum. Next, connect the battery and wait until you get a tone. Now bring your throttle stick to minimum position and again wait for some time until you get some beep sounds. Now remove the battery. Make sure you do this for all the ESCs. Next, we have to calibrate the ESCs using the flight controller. For this, you have to complete all the connections of your quadcopter and then switch on the transmitter. Now increase the throttle to maximum position and power your quadcopter. Leave it for 5 seconds and disconnect your power supply. Then again connect your power supply, and after you get 2 beep sounds, decrease the throttle to minimum position and wait for 5 seconds. Then remove the power supply. So it's done. Now if you arm your quadcopter, all the motors will be rotating in the same RPM. Now compare all your motor directions with this layout. If any of the motor is rotating in the opposite direction, keep this yellow wire as it is and just exchange red and black wires. Finally, we need to fix the propellers. For the clockwise rotating motors, fix the propeller on which there is capital letter R written on that. Now everything is done. Let's check how it works. I hope you guys like this video. In the coming days, I'll make an outdoor flight test. So stay tuned for that video. Thank you for watching this video, guys. If you have any doubts, please ask in the comment section. I'll see you in the next one.